So because the mixing tanks are using some AF templates, I currently only have one display made, but I effectively have four displays because we have four tanks. So I can simply use a switch asset tab here and switch between the different assets. And if you notice, we can see the product, the density, and the name, everything changes. And our multistate will also use the updated point. So let's go back to mixing tank 1 and let's enhance our display even more. So maybe I'm not interested in having four different displays for my tanks, but I only want to see the tanks that have a specific behavior. So if I click and select everything here, so I have the asset name, I have my table, and my graphic. I can right-click anywhere and hit convert to collection. What a collection is a quick overview of all my assets that are based on the same template. And the way it works is that in this case, I will have all my tanks and I want to display all the tanks that have a specific behavior. Let's say the level is greater than 4. It can really be anything. So here, because I want all my tanks and not just the production line 1, I will make sure that the search root, which is the top of my AF hierarchy, will be production area. So if we look once more at our AF hierarchy that we're working on, by using production area, I will have all 4 of my tanks here. And I want to return all the descendants. In this case, I want all the tanks that have this template, so the general tank template. But maybe I don't want to see all 4 of them at all time. I may be interested in only seeing when the level is, let's say, greater than 4. I could have more than one attribute, but let's just stick with 1 for right now. Okay, so let's take a look at our display now. So we can see that at this time, all 4 of my assets have the level greater than 4, and therefore they're all showing up. But let's move in time and let's see if that changes. So let's maybe look at a different criteria. Maybe I want to look at the external temperature being less than 200. Now we can see at this time, there's only one tank that has the external temperature less than 200. But if I move in time, this gives me a really quick overview. So using collections and using multistate is a very great way to have one display, but showing a lot more than just what you're putting in here. So it helps to have a quick overview. So we'll jump on to a few little demos and then you'll have an exercise where you can practice all of those. So let's go ahead and create a new display. So in your workbook, you can follow the graphics, multistate behavior, collections, and asset table in PyVision exercise. So in this one, we're asked to have a tank graphic library. So I will move here to the graphic library. I will simply add one of the tanks on my display. So now I have my tank. I will add a vertical gauge for the mixing tank 1. So we can simply browse to mixing tank 1, or you can search for mixing tank 1 as well. I'm selecting the vertical gauge, and then I can add the level here. For this gauge, we'll want to add a multistate. And for the multistate, we don't want to use the level, we'll want to use the external temperature. So I can simply remove the level. And drop the external temperature. here we can see that I can change the color of any of my states. And if it is a critical state, maybe I want it to blink as well. So in this case, my gauge will blink. The next one, we ask to add a value symbol above the tank graphic. So let's quickly select both of them, move them down, and add a value symbol. So I'll select my value and then I will do the drag and drop. So now I can see that I'm using mixing tank 1. As we've seen, let's turn this into a collection. So now I have a collection that is based on all the tanks. As described in the directed activity, we want to get everything for the production area. This is important because if I do not do this, I will only get the production line 1, therefore mixing tank 1 and storage tank 1. I will not have the production line 2. For the asset type, we'll use our template. And in this case, for the asset attribute, we ask to do the level less than 4. So great, now we have a collection. In this case, currently, none of them have a level less than 4, but our collection is still here. The last thing we'll add is the asset comparison table. We'll have the asset name and the installation date. Great, I have my asset name and my installation date, but I want to see it for all my tanks. So let's use the search that we've seen before. So I will search for tank. And I can also add my other tanks to my asset comparison table. And there we go. We have a collection, and then we have the asset comparison table. And for my collection, if I just right-click, I can also change what I want. Maybe I want the level being less than 6. And now we can see I can have all my different tanks here that have a level of less than 6. So this is just a very quick overview to be able to compare a variety of pieces of equipment, a variety of assets. So I now invite you to move on to the exercise, and once you're done, we'll go through the solution together.